Now, taking a look at this damper, this is what I would be seeing on the outside. Now, there's usually some sort of filter over this, something that stops small birds and rocks, but that's about it. But this is the outside air. This damper here is going to open to allow outside air in. Now, these parts here are kind of interesting because these are barometric dampers. They communicate inside with the return air. So that if this damper is wide open and moving a lot of air into the structure, now that can increase the pressure inside the structure. So if the return air is coming back at a positive pressure compared to outside, then because there's so much air moving in here, then these are going to start opening. And they will dump that excess air outside. Now understand, this is a cooling mechanism, so we're using outside air to cool, and when I dump this return air, I'm not really losing, you know, cooled air inside the house, because this is the return air, and it's bringing back warm air into the return, so I'm just dumping some warm air outside. So that's two of the sets of dampers. The barometrics here, and this is the outside air damper. Let's take a look at the inside of this thing. Now here we're looking at the inside, and I'm going to move these dampers so you can see what's going on between taking outside air and inside air. But right now, this is the return air down here. This is return air coming up. And those barometric dampers that I was talking about earlier, they're right there. Okay, this is allowing return air to come back and be cooled by the compressor. This is the outside air damper. It's virtually closed, so it's all return air coming in here. Now I'm going to move these dampers to the opposite position where I'm taking more outside air than I am inside air, and you can take a look at that. Okay, I don't know how well you can hear in here, but you can see these dampers are moving. And as one closes, the other opens. And we'll take a look at it once they've gone the entire way. Now, let's take a look at what's happened. This is a return air damper. They're not completely closed, but it's almost closed. This is the outside air damper. You can see it's wide open. And so with this being the return coming back this way, instead of taking return air, the most of the air that is being brought in is coming from outside. And this is going to cool with outside air. Now, what makes all this stuff do this? Let's take a look at that next. Okay, here's what is driving this whole thing. This is a mod motor, and there's actually two parts to this thing. Now, this is actually the mod motor here. Now, this is a partial turn motor. It makes a stroke of, I don't know, this is about half a turn, 180 or so. But this is the motor itself. The motor, and of course it's a gear motor and the like, the motor is mostly controlled by this control here. Now, this thing is what does most of the deciding of what to happen. There's inputs, there are temperature inputs from it, sometimes enthalpy inputs, there's power inputs from the thermostat, and so on. But this pretty much tells it what to do. We've got a number of little pots in here. Minimum position is the most commonly used one, but this controls that. This is kind of the gathering point for all the inputs, and then those inputs are put into the economizer motor. So let's take a look at what is telling this what's going on. In order to see this control, I pulled it off. It's normally mounted right up in here, like that. Now this is sensing outside air temperature, because here's my outside air damper and this is the outside here. So this thing here, this can either be an enthalpy control or it can be just a thermostat. It's actually, well, a thermometer is actually what it is. This one is not an enthalpy control. Enthalpy control determines how much outside air to bring in depending on the humidity, the temperature and humidity of the air. This one only uses temperature. Humidity is oftentimes used in warmer climates that have a lot of humidity, but this is up from north, and mostly a simple thermometer will do. And it's feeding input into the control for the mod motor. So it's going to tell the mod motor control that the outside air is or is not the right temperature to bring it in to provide, quote, free cooling. Now, I will note there's another temperature control. It's called a mixed air temperature control. Now, I don't have one on this one. I didn't get it when I got the economizer, but it's downstream where the return air, which is down this way and down, is coming up. It's mixing with the outside air. Then I get a temperature before it goes into the fan that mixes the two. And that gives me an idea of what temperature the air is going in there. That also tells the mod motor control what the mixed air temperature is so it can adjust these dampers back and forth to get the right temperature. Okay, that's pretty much the components of it. The next thing we're going to go into is we'll start looking at things like minimum position on the dampers and some adjustments on this thing.